Hello, this is a bit strange. I'm not much of a storyteller, but hopefully you will find something I say interesting or thought-provoking. This is a series called Testimony Tuesday that our church has recorded over 2020. If you haven't seen any of the others, I would recommend taking a look through the videos. I'm sure there is someone in it that could really speak to you. This is a wee bit about my life. I'm Josh, I'm 23, I'm married to Hayley. I go to Trinity Grey Abbey. I work as an engineer and I like building things. I suppose my main interest has always been construction. From as young as I can remember, I've always been putting something together, and as I've got older, my projects have got bigger and slower. There are some constructions I love to think about. Our future home I plan to build, a Ford Anglia that's in bits, and lots of other rally cars, particularly 6R4 Metros. But the best construction has to be the world we live in, the creation around us. My testimony is probably fairly similar to most. I'm blessed to have grown up with Christian parents who brought me to church each week. I went to BB and the children's stuff and everything was great. If you ask me when I became a Christian, I couldn't really tell you, as I can remember praying to God, asking him to forgive my past, be with me in the present and change my future on many occasions. One that stands out and is easy to put a date to is April 2008, as there was an event on at the Odyssey called the Celebration of Hope. I can remember being there and crying my eyes out, although I was sitting next to my parents, so I was trying to act casual at the same time. I knew then that there was a creator, that he has created the world, and that even though I didn't understand all the bits of the Bible and what the minister was saying, the creation that I seen was enough to trust. My secondary school years were similar to most young Christians, where you have challenges and doubts and a bit of independence. And I had my ups and downs, doubting if this was for real and if this was for me, and really thinking about the claims of the Bible. Not as a child anymore, but as someone studying physics and searching for the answers to the big questions. At the time, the church was doing construction work and I was down helping to paint or doing what I could, and it seemed like a bit of a pivotal moment in my Christian life. I went from someone going to church and to someone wanting to get involved. I volunteered as a leader and started to understand the church family, the support there is, but also the crack. I went on mission trips to Latvia and Croatia, which changed how I viewed the world and God. Worshipping with people in languages that I didn't understand, and it made me realise that this wasn't something we did in Grey Abbey or Northern Ireland, but that God is worldwide. Since then, I've spent lots of time listening to people like John Lennox debate Genesis and creation, and I believe that the claims in the Bible are true, that God is eternal, that he created the world just as he said he did, and that he is the king and the judge for our eternal life. I heard a minister say recently, if you knew all the answers that you would be God. And that has helped me to know that we can try, but that we can't work out all the answers. So that's where I'm at. The tagline of this series is Jesus changing lives. Jesus has changed my life. He has given me a different purpose. He's changed how I view the world and life itself. He has forgiven the wrongs that I have done and has given me eternal life. But Jesus is still changing my life. I still mess up. I still do my own thing and I still hurt people. Probably daily. But that is the thing about Christianity. God wants you as you are. One of my favourite bits of the Bible is the thief on the cross. It talks about it in Luke. Whenever the thief's on the cross talking to Jesus, he's in a helpless place and he has seconds of his life counting down, and he speaks to Jesus. And Jesus replies to him saying, today you will be with me in paradise. It doesn't matter where you are in life, what you've done in your past, Jesus can change your life too. Thanks for watching.